I know we're live.
Live.
Oh, hi everybody, Dr. Kazi over here at Kazi Cosmetic Clinic in Irvine, California. And today I'm using Restylane Kiss on this patient for her lips. She wants something very natural, so it's a very good product for that. And what I'm working on right now is her cupid's bow area and that vermilion border. That's how we can get a nice, crisp, beautiful border for her. I'm using a pillar technique to help pull up the lip. And so we could actually just make it keep it looking very natural and subtle for her. You don't mind smile for me? A big, big smile. Oh, with your teeth? There we go. So see the gummy smile right over here too. We're correcting that. We're doing a little bit of Botox to help correct that. Sometimes it's also due to volume loss too. And so when we do these fillers, actually, this is going to help as well for that. All right, you can relax. Thank you. So a lot of patients come to me with thinner lips, especially. They're asking for subtle. They don't want overwhelming because they find that that's going to look too unnatural for their face. And I tend to agree, really, you have to keep it so that the lips look proportional. So you're going to see a little oozing, that's no big deal. The lips are highly vascular. We do have multiple ways of doing numbing. In this case, I just did topical, but for some people, I could also do injectable numbing, so there's a complete nerve block, and they really almost feel nothing then. I'm going to go back and work on this a little bit more. So nothing too crazy, just something to give a little definition, make it really pop, a little hydration. You guys that have been following me for a little while know how I do it. I really try not to make it look or appear as if it's sticking out too much. I really dislike that look. So you can see one side is already really pretty much lifted right here. I'm going to work a little bit more on that right side. If you come in closer, you can see how that is, that border, that definition there. So this is really nice for definition, for structure. It's pretty subtle for volume. So if you want a lot of volume, I have other options for that. But it's really nice as kind of a foundation for your lips. So this particular filler, there's studies show that it lasts about 1 year. Everyone metabolizes fillers differently though. Some people last a little longer, some people a little bit less. It just all depends on your body. But for the vast majority of people, it's about 1 year. And if you guys watch my talk with a physician that was in Australia, Dr. Lim, we were talking about how you could actually see fillers years later on MRI, so there's still sometimes a little bit of residual filler there. So it's good when it's placed properly, but sometimes if it's placed improperly, it could stay there and linger, and you really have to dissolve it. So So I do avoid certain kinds of fillers, especially in the lips. Thick fillers like Juvederm Ultra Plus are not really appropriate for a lot of patients. I know people have heard that name before, but I find that it moves too much, it causes too much inflammation, and that inflammatory process could cause nodules in the future. So I tend to avoid it unless people request it or, you know, if they really want that a lot of volume. But we have so many good options otherwise, though. So again, if you come in closer, you can see difference between one side and the other. I did do a little bit on the right side, but you can see that definition, and this lower lip is actually coming together now too. We're getting that nice and redefined too. Another thing people always ask is, do you use a full vial? It really depends. I'm not gonna fill you up more than you really need to. That's how you end up getting those lumps and bumps, and it can look a little awkward. So it really depends on how much room we have for filler. But I could tell you, I pretty much never do more than one syringe per session. I know there was like this meme that was going around from some other practitioners. They were talking about how filler really only has, I think they were saying basically less than a ketchup, a little ketchup packet. There's 5 cc's in a ketchup packet, and there's only 1 cc over here. But it's kind of inaccurate though, because the structure and nature of this is much different though than what ketchup is really. This is purposely supposed to expand, and it's supposed to cause definition. So if you load up that same amount in lips, for example, of 5 cc's of this, it'll be a disaster. We're just building this pout here. Again, it's gonna ooze a little bit. Lips highly vascular. Mind holding this at this spot right here? Thank you. I'm going to build a little bit more of the Cupid's bow. And this pinches just a little bit too. But that really makes it pop. And this is the part that everyone loves. They love when they have that really sharp Cupid's bow. So doing lips with Wrestling Kiss. This is your first time lips for this patient. Now what I'm doing down here is trying to pull down this lower lip a little bit. Again, she wants things to look natural, although I told her that there's gonna be more swelling initially, and you're gonna really like that swelling, you're gonna want that swelling. And that's usually the situation for most of my patients. They initially almost always say, I really, really want it subtle, don't want anyone to know. And then after 4 days, they say, can I please get some more? Because I really like that swollen look. So, just gonna finish a couple spots, but you can take a look over here as we kind of pause bleeding for a second here. This is where we are right now. And one more shot over here. You can take a look and show the differences. And just gonna patch up a little bit, some more areas here. But we're pretty much almost done. Thank you guys. Thanks for joining us.